Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube class on C programming. In this video we are going to talk about writing the output of few of the question on the nested if else. Now what I want to you to do is I want you to pause the video right over here and try to write down the output of both of these questions. Please pause the video, give yourself some time and try to write down the answer based on whatever we have studied just now on the nested if else. Okay, let's see the output of this. Now I say int x equal to 5. Now this is the variable x whose value is 5. Let the address of this variable be say 0x1000. You can assume any address that you like, and 0x means it is hexadecimal. Now you first check the condition over here. 5 greater than 5 is false. Since it is false, you come to the body of else. Now body of else should be executed. Now 5 equal equal 5, yes it is true, therefore it will print 2 as the output. Now notice one thing, this is a separate if and this is a separate if else. This is a separate if and this is a separate if else. Now 5 greater than 10, it is false, therefore it will print 4 as output. Hence the output of this question is 2 and 4. Now let's see the output of this question B. Now there is a variable x. Let the address of this we say 0x2000, and what is the initial value of x? The initial value of x is garbage. That is the initial value of x, which is garbage because we did not initialize anything. Now first the condition should be evaluated in if. Now before this we haven't given any brackets, then how do we know what is if and what is the body of if and all. Now this is the body of this particular if and this is the body of this particular else. This is the body of this particular else, and these two together will make if else. Now this complete thing is the body of this else and body of this if, and this is the body of the else, right? This complete thing is the body of if and this is the body of else. Now how does it will evaluate? There is a variable x whose value is garbage. We say scanf read the value of x. Now we said that assume the value of x entered is 0. That means this garbage is overwritten with 0. Now what does scanf returns? Scanf returns the number of variables successfully read. And how many variables are being successfully read over here? This is one variable which is being successfully read. And what is the variable? That is x. That means this complete scanf is replaced by 1. Now 1 is true. That means this body of if and if should be executed. That means this if else should be executed. Now what is the value of x? It is 0. 0 is false, therefore else should be executed. And what is the output of this question? The output of this question is 2. The output of this question is 2. Thank you friends for watching my video. I hope you have liked it. Please like to this video, subscribe to my channel and share this channel with your friends. This completes the nested if else, and in the next video we are going to talk about the else if ladder. Thank you very much for watching.